Hi, welcome to Automation Testing That In. In this video, we will see handling authentication pop-up in Selenium. Then what do you mean by authentication pop-up? So first we'll see when you go to any website, the login page looks something like this. Not exactly this, it may be different, but you'll have a username and text box, password and text box, and login button or submit button or OK button, whatever it may be. But when you want to work with Selenium, you have to enter username and password in these text boxes. Then how you find these elements and you can enter something into this. So for that, you'll just inspect and you'll try to take XPath or CSS selector or ID, whatever the locator you will take, and you'll find that element and you'll interact with these elements. The reason is you can find these elements, right? You see, I'm finding this element, name equal to username, and go to the password, name equal to password. And when you go to the login button, you have something type equal to submit. You have some properties, but sometimes you will have some of the URLs like this, the-internet.herokoapp.com/basic. When I hit enter, you see that it will ask you for the username and password, something like this. This is a pop-up. When you come here, this is not a pop-up. This is the part of your HTML page, but here, this is not part of HTML page. This is a pop-up. And you cannot identify this pop-up. If I want to inspect this, if I right-click, you see that you are not getting this inspect option. How you are getting in this page? You see that inspect. But when you come here, you cannot inspect this. When I'm trying to inspect the sign-in button, I'm not getting anything. For cancel also, I'm not getting anything. So you cannot find these elements using any locators. So how you can handle this type of websites? How you log into this application, otherwise how you navigate to this web page. Without giving this username and password, you cannot enter into this web page. So when I say cancel, you see that no authorization. When I hit enter once again, it will ask you for the credentials. So the credentials are admin and admin. When I click sign in now, you see that basic app. Congratulations, you must have proper credentials. This kind of web page will appear when you go with the valid credentials. Then how you'll handle this kind of pop-ups? And one more thing is, when you go to the same URL with Firefox, you see that here also same thing, but the look and feel of this pop-up is different now. Okay, here you have OK, cancel, but when you go to the Chrome, you see that here you are finding sign in button. When you go to the Firefox, here you have OK button. Means the pop-up is also a bit different from browser to browser. So in these situations, people will say that use third-party tools like AutoIT, SQLite to handle this kind of pop-ups. So when you go with that option, it will work. But the problem is SQLite and AutoIT will work with this UI elements. So if you have OK button, the same OK button should be available to that SQLite or AutoIT to handle. But when you write that logic using SQLite or AutoIT, it may work with Google or Firefox, any one of these. The reason is you will take any one of these pop-up. When you take Firefox pop-up, it will only work with Firefox. If you take Chrome pop-up, it will only work with Chrome pop-up. Then that is not constant. Then how you handle this kind of situations? And it should be unique. Means the logic which you are using should be consistent for all the browsers. So we have a simple solution for this in Selenium. That is, when your website looks something like this, http://www.website.com. But this website is accepting, means this website is having authentication pop-up, then you need to pass your username and password through your URL. How is that? You see here, http://username:password@www.yourwebsite.com. When you pass something like this, then it will not even ask for your credentials. So we will see by writing a logic or code practically. So for this, go to IntelliJ. Here I'll create a Java class handling authentication popup. Okay. Now, first I'll work with Chrome. So I'll take this logic from other program. Okay, here I'm taking Chrome browser. System.set property webdriver.chrome.driver and path to the chrome driver.exe and webdriver driver equal new chrome driver. Here, what I'll do, driver.get. Here I'll pass the URL which I want. What is that URL? Just we have seen that this URL. Now, when I try to run this program, first we'll see how it will be. You see that it is asking for the credentials. So how you will supply these credentials? Now I'll close this. Now we'll supply the username and password through this URL. How it will be? Before that, what I'll do, I'll take Firefox driver. We'll see how it looks like. Gecko driver and then Firefox driver, and I'll run this. You see that it is also asking the same thing. So I'm cancelling this. Now we'll provide the username and password through our URL. How it will be? After double forward slash, you need to provide username colon password and you need to mention @. This is the thing you have to follow, right? Username colon password and @. So now I'll run the same thing. Now we'll see what will happen. You see that it is directly logged into your application. That is the reason you are seeing basic congratulations message, right? And the same way, now I'll execute the same thing with Chrome. Chrome driver. Chrome driver. So I'm not changing the URL. Now I'll run this one. You see that it is directly logged into the application. That is the reason you are seeing basic auth and congratulations message. This is how you have to handle authentication pop-ups in Selenium. The reason is, when you go with this approach, if the browser changes also, your logic will not change, means your code will not fail. So when you have an authentication pop-up in your web page, then you just follow this approach to log into your application, and this is very simple and it is consistent across all the browsers. That's all in this video. Thank you for watching this video. Please like us on our Facebook page and please subscribe to YouTube channel for further updates, and please like the video, share the video.